Okay, hi. Hi.
Hi.
I'm Kiersten. It's nice to meet you. I feel like we have our own David Letterman set.
Yes, very tiny.
It's very, very tiny. Thank you for sitting down with me between two ferns or plants. And I wanted to just ask some questions and we can just chat.
All right.
About this weird life we have.
So, okay. Yeah.
Okay. So the first question I wanted to ask you, as my husband, Scott Hathcock, who has lived with me through all of this crazy madness that is called intuition, is what was that like for you when I first started seeing people in spirit?
I don't remember the very first time. I honestly don't. I just remember when it was happening quite a bit, you know? Mm-hmm. And I think at that point, I just trusted you, you know? I think it was an unusual thing to have thrown upon us. But I think that in the end, I just trusted you and had some intuitive hits as well, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That made that even feel safer.
Yeah. Do you remember that night when we were laying in bed and you said, hey, do you see her in the corner?
I do. I think I remember her having long black hair or something like that. Yeah, no, I did. It was a moment, you know, it was a period of that time too that, and I think because I was so much around you, mm-hmm. that maybe I started opening up as well and had the ability to see, not to the extent that you could see, but had ability to see. And so it was kind of fun. But I knew it wasn't my thing to do. And so I didn't really pursue it.
So did you, if you look back on your life, do you feel like you were intuitive prior to, you know, everything
totally.
That happened to me?
Yeah, I was probably more intuitive than you were. Agreed. Initially in our younger lives. I always had intuitive hits with regards to my own path. And mm-hmm. mine seemed to follow, like, what was right for me, kind of intuitive stuff. Yeah. Not any, you know, not the ability to think about anybody else mm-hmm. in the sense of imagining where their life was going. But I would have intuitive hits periodically. And, you know, I remember one time I was in a car and I was thinking about moving to L.A. long time before you and I met. Mm. And I was thinking about moving to LA, and I remember I was in sort of a half sleep, mm-hmm. and I had that feeling of it's going to be okay if you do that. And it just felt like this rush of chills, mm-hmm. and it felt godlike. Like, it felt like a sense that God was saying, yes, go do that thing, trust yourself, go do that. And then I didn't. You know, and then we put it off for, you know, 15 years or whatever at the time.
And then you met me in a bar.
Exactly. But I think the point was is that, you know, I'd had moments like that. You know, mm-hmm. obviously when we sold our house and we decided mm-hmm. to move to California, mm-hmm. I had another big moment that night as we're both in tears and we had just signed our contracts. And I just knew we had walked the red carpet. And mm-hmm. that's such an odd thing to even think about, given that we didn't have jobs and we had just decided to move to California without mm-hmm. a job. But I just knew in a year from now, no, why even I put a date to it? But in a year from now, we would walk the red carpet. Mm-hmm. And then we did.
Yeah.
And it wasn't under the framework of what I had imagined mm-hmm. with as an actor or as a screenwriter or some sort of production person. It was as a person taking a client to, you know, the Emmys.
Yeah.
And so what I've learned over time is sometimes the way you imagine it is not as quite defined mm-hmm. as what you, I guess, your ego wants you to connect mm-hmm. the dots and see something a little bit more clear. And it's not always that way, but it happens. And so those were probably my two biggest ones that I had in the past.
Just a quick side note. Do you remember that night? This is probably synchronicity too. Remember, I almost ran over Jennifer Love Hewitt,
mm-hmm,
who is the lead actress and the Ghost Whisperer.
Yes.
But this was prior to
any of this
yeah, stuff. And when I was, what was that? 2004.
I think so. Yeah.
And I think I started channeling pretty hardcore in 2010. So it was prior to that. But anyway, she's still alive.
Yes.
I didn't run over her.
Right. No, we did not.
And she's not the only Ghost Whisperer, apparently.